So do you have kids and stuff? Do you have a life outside of, what's your life outside of music?
Why are you laughing, bro? You're a father, fam.
Welcome back to the greatest show on planet Earth, people. This is GASWORKS. Hey, make some noise, everyone. Make some noise. You get me? Season 3. We've got a few special guests today, but would you put your money on them actually turning up?
I mean, I can only hope and pray.
Mm. Hope and pray.
One of them's the size of the building, so I hope he gets in.
Wow.
Might have to do the interview outside or something.
Oh, my Lord. Yeah. How do you get away with saying all of this all the time?
I say it to his face, but he wears a mask. But you know what it is? I think it's because of coronavirus.
Yeah.
He's actually the most prepared. There's a few...
He's a visionary.
Like, LD would be prepared. Cassie's dead would be prepared.
Yeah.
And our special guest today would be prepared.
And the Queen.
She can fuck off. I still...
She drives a lit, though.
This guy said tradition, you know. You know what? No, I clocked it. I clocked it, yeah. Mm. I'm going to take back everything I said about Harry and Meghan. They can fuck off. Yeah. No, listen, listen. I'll tell you why, yeah. How much did their wedding cost? Was it 40 million or something?
Yeah.
Was it?
I don't know.
Whatever the million was, yeah. Mm-hmm. So you know he came out in that interview and he's like, oh, if you knew what I knew, you'd do the same.
Yeah.
But if you knew what you knew, like, you can't say that after you've just taken everyone's money for a fucking wedding.
But say he found out after he took the money.
No. What? So he... How much? 32 million. Come on, stop it, man. Come on.
That's still cheaper than Cristiano Ronaldo. That's still cheaper than...
Yeah, but that man worked for their own money. He's not...
They're trying to escape now.
Listen, I like Meghan a lot. I like Harry a lot. They're probably... If I had to pick a favourite of the royals... Who would I pick, actually? Probably Prince Andrew. He's done his thing. But he's out here,
Is it because you found out that your cousin's with Boris Johnson, so now you feel
yes, my guy.
Yes. Come on, my guy. Stay loyal,
you also
bro.
Found out that your cousin's with...
Who?
Is it Mira May?
What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? Know. Yeah, I'm cousins with Mira May.
No, you're not. You just lived in the same area. But that's the same with me and Boris. We both grew up in Turkey together.
Oh, is it?
And today's special guest also grew up in Turkey as well.
Oh, he is Turkish, yeah. So Mehmet. We found it.
Yeah.
That's just confirmed. Huncho is Turkish.
But back to the royal family.
Yeah.
I bigged them up last episode, mm-hmm. but I'm going to have to take it back. Because it's massive role. Harry's like, if you knew what I knew, you'd do the same. But bro, you spent 32 million. You can't say that. I don't think he spent it though. Oh, come off it, man.
The club spent it, just like in football.
So he's going to go district.
Don't get angry at the player.
If the after party was at district, I'd understand. But they wouldn't let Meghan in because they're racist.
Mm, they're district. But I think, if I'm being totally honest with you, I really like them a lot. They've escaped. They've left Love Island. They're going to stay together. I think it's really great.
No, we're not talking about Wes. That's finished. That ship has sailed.
Well, Wes, can he put his jumper on now?
Jaws was a great film.
So you're saying Wes looks like Jaws?
I had to say that joke again because he didn't go into the last episode.
Is it? Yeah, that's my brand now. I don't blame you.
Nah.
Why this virus thing? Is it really bad? I heard it's in France, by the way.
It's everywhere. It's called house music.
What?
Yeah, coronavirus is long. They named it after a beer, so Muslims can't get it. We're good.
Damn it. I'm definitely not good.
Coronavirus. Do you drink Corona?
No, I don't drink Corona, but like...
But you look like Corona.
What do you mean I look like Corona?
You just look like a Corona bottle.
What? What do you mean?
You just look like a Corona bottle.
You look like a fridge, fam. Nah, don't fuck up, man.
No, today's guest looks like a fridge. Don't tell me I look like a
fridge. Oh my God, did you see that rock party dinner thing?
A Rock Nation brunch.
Yeah, what it's called.
But what's everyone's fascination with it?
Bro, I don't get it.
Yeah,
well, if everyone, like, maybe I'm jealous a little bit, but I just think, like, you know, like you go there just to take a picture, but none of you are next to Jay-Z.
If that was in the UK, you'd be the first person there.
No, I wouldn't.
Come on, bro.
I don't go anywhere.
No.
If it was in my living room, I'd go.
What?
If it was in my living room, I'd go. I don't go anywhere, Alhan.
Do you remember?
You put me down on guest list for Huncho's thing,
yeah.
And you didn't even tell me.
But you were upset with me.
Because at least let me know.
Yeah, but you would go.
Huncho or go, but I'm not gonna.
Because the thing is, yeah.
I wouldn't be allowed
I hear you, I hear you.
I don't think I'll be allowed anyway.
Wait, so the Rock Nation bunch, if it was in the UK. Yeah. What would it be called here? What, Island Break? What record label would do it?
What's the record label that helps?
Disturbing London? Who would do it?
I don't know. I wouldn't feel safe at them ones anyway. I wouldn't feel safe at any event with huge amounts of people.
So what, you wouldn't go to the. If there was a.
I think we should be invited.
We should make a Gasworks bunch. Why don't we have the power in our hands?
I like that.
Yeah.
And then we should do a talk. We should get a comedian to do a talk about writing a book. But I just need to think who would. Harry Panero.
But who's going to write the book?
I don't know. Kevin Hart was talking about a book and then everyone raised their drink.
Right.
And they were like, oh my God, yeah.
Yeah,
what
Harry.
What chapter do you want next?
And Harry, like, Specs. Hey, brother, everyone. We're the comedians as well, you know.
Relative. For me.
But we'll take a day off. We'll say, have your fun.
I like that.
You get me? Ooh. We're saying no, coronavirus.
I really don't want that.
It's the new Ebola, bird flu. Catch it, bein' it, kill it.
Do the catch dance. It, bein' it, kill it. I see him all the time. J Dolph.
Okay.
What a hero. He got signed. That song got signed.
Yeah, by the NHS. What would the coronavirus be? Long. But yeah, I was saying, it's China, innit? They make everything. Problems.
M. Huncho's mask. Should we call him in?
No, M. Huncho's mask wasn't made in China.
Where was it?
Turkey.
100%?
100%. Aye. You get me? But, is there anything else to talk about? Well, so Kobe Bryant passed away. Rest in peace.
That was fucking sad, bro.
Rest in peace. He was actually, he's a hero in Turkey, you know? Like M. Huncho. But Kobe Bryant was a hero in Turkey because he was part of the Turkish Airlines commercial with Messi.
Oh my lord.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, I do. I went on a flight to Mauritius and I went Turkey halfway. Yeah. Turkey is really nice.
Don't eat our ass. We're good.
Well, you eat our ass.
You know what I've clocked?
Whole community.
Oh, fuck off. That's because it tastes nice.
Coronavirus. Go on.
Wow. Whoa, a bit racist. Get me? No, but I noticed you've been bigging up the Green Lanes Turkish community a lot.
Fam, I love them.
You got beef all of a sudden?
No, but I remember what happened when the riots happened.
Yeah.
Everyone went down there to try and rob stuff and they weren't on it. And I was really happy about that.
We've done our thing.
You weren't there?
I was.
When the riots kicked off, you were like 12.
Ask him, Huncho, he's there as well.
Yeah, I believe that.
Because my dad's shop is next to his dad's shop.
Wait. You got a shop in Green Lanes?
Come on, man. No.
Oh.
Well, I was listening to his album on the way here. What did he say?
Cult boy.
Some people are here to build a foundation, but others are here to... But was it someone's here to build the legacy or something?
Oh, so he can make the speech, that Kevin Hart them.
Yeah, why don't we let him... But it wasn't him that made the speech, it was a speech about him.
Oh,
yeah, very nice.
Harry Panero's.
But what's happened with Harry?
No, I saw him interview him, Huncho. Maybe he'd made the speech.
Oh, yeah, the event that we would have been at.
But you didn't tell me about it.
Oh, I'm not going to go, am I?
We can't go now, it's impossible.
No, yeah. Well, I'm going to go and sit down and listen to M. Huncho when I'm going to do that here. It was long.
At least I could have had the option.
So you wanted to go?
I can't go now.
No, but did you want to go?
Well, in hindsight, you can say whatever you want.
Would you have gone?
Nah.
All right, then.
Yeah, I think I would have gone, you know. I wasn't doing anything as well. And M. Huncho was a really nice guy. You just don't tell no one nothing.
Bro, can't bother, man. People, none other than one of the greatest Turkish artists in the world. Yeah, second greatest Turkish artist in the world. M. Huncho!
Fuck you up. I'm just gonna fuck you up. How do you know I'm Turkish?
Come on.
I'm not from your country, bro.
How are you?
I think I would have looked like you, bro. Mm. Yeah.
Madonna's Turkish.
Bro, this guy, have you been to Best Kebab before? Have you been to Best Kebab? Stoke Newington.
Yes, I have. Yeah.
Have you not seen Alhan's picture there, bro?
You got a picture there?
Bro, they've got a picture of every staff member. It looks like an 11-a-side team first in the lineup, bro. And the last three, the centre-backs, they all look like Alhan.
Hey, Mehmet, how are you, Mehmet, man? Talking of centre-backs, you do look like an American football player, the way you're built.
I used to try and play it here and there, to
really?
Be honest, yeah.
Was it NFL, NBA?
No, NFL.
NFL, how's NFL?
What do you think, Alhan? NFL or NBA? National Football League or National Basketball Association?
NBA. Hey, welcome. I make some noise for Mehmet, everyone. So what does the M Corona. In M Huncho stand for? Because I think it's Mehmet.
It just stands for M, money.
That's it, money. Money Huncho. Huncho in the first. I was listening to the album on the way here. You smashed it.
Thank you, bro.
Every song like sounds like the other song, but they're all different in their own way. I think they're amazing. My favourite was Head Huncho. Smashed it. Free Heady,
yeah. For real.
But yeah, it's a great album.
Appreciate it, man.
I was going to come to the launch, but Poet told me not to come, so.
My brother, he didn't even tell me. You came in here, bro, and told me you know my full name. That's
crazy. I already know what he said. I was standing right there. To be honest with you,
yeah,
I'm not even going to fucking invite you next time.
I don't. But you can come to our, but when we do a Gasworks bunch, you can come to that.
But definitely not, and I'm not doing that. No way.
Why?
What do you mean, fam? Tip tap, bro. I'm not going to come to your fucking...
All right, fine.
Gasworks brunch, some budget brunch in fucking Roundwood Park in Halsden, bro.
Whoa, definitely not Halsden.
Bro, I know you. He would do something like that, you know?
Nah, bro, not Halsden.
Look at me, bro. Do you think he will not do something stupid?
Yeah, but I don't mind like West Green Road. It's funny. Bare Jamaicans, but not Halsden.
Man's just going to take Manhala.
Nah, not Hala. Yeah, Gokizu, 100%.
Where's
See,
that?
Look at the Green Lanes. There's one in Finchley, Chingford, Walthamstow.
He knows.
Bad boy. You know.
Maybe you are,
Mehmet. They're definitely paying you to be the fucking taster guy.
I need the black card still.
You think them Turks are going to give you a black card?
I know.
The only free thing they'll give you is probably a rice pudding.
And even then they won't. No, but I can't lie. Turks are the worst people to give anything free to.
Why?
Because they'll just take everything.
Like your culture, we gave it to you for free. Nah, Look what you do. Nah, you're right. Nah, you're like Christopher Columbus.
Nah. It's funny that it's called a black card, isn't it? Tie that bandana, man. But there's a question we like to ask all our special guests.
No.
And that question is, are you a bokeh?
Really. Yeah.
You're not a bokeh?
No, bro.
Why?
Not with that mask.
Coronavirus.
It's just, you ask me a question, I say no, we move
on. Yeah, but why? Don't just say no. There's an explanation behind everything. There's a reason for everything.
Like, obviously, I don't believe to do it with just any random person. Obviously, I'm going to wait until I'm married. Or, like, you know what I'm trying to say? In that context, then, yeah, but...
What about Emilio after your chicken shop? Nah.
He looks like he's done that to Emilio, bro. More than
wow. I can't lie. Your chicken shop was one of the funniest
best
ones.
Best.
Thank you.
By
it
far.
Was. Yeah, 100%.
On, effortless. You just weren't having any of her banter at all.
You know what it is? She's an awkward person, isn't it? So you have to approach her very awkwardly.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You clocked it?
100%, and I clocked you as well. I've been doing my research.
Yeah?
Yeah, man.
What do you know?
Bro, come on, man. I see you driving in and out of like certain areas in North London. I see you all the time, bro.
That's such a vague, I see you driving in North London.
No. Not just that, bro. Like,
Stevie Wonder see me driving in North London, bro.
Yo, I can follow you like this, you know. I can just go to exactly where you live, post up outside, just be like, yeah. I found a plug for best kebab. He's got $50 in his garden posted. Like, listen, I've got a drop on this guy.
Come on, what else do you know?
I know quite a lot, but I don't like to.
Oh, come on, surprise us.
I know something we don't know, what you look like. Does it kind of annoy you that everyone wants to know what you look like?
It doesn't really annoy me, to be honest with you. It's just a bit weird sometimes.
Do you not think it's a bit like Big Zoo?
What do you mean? I look exactly like Big Z.
He's got the same eyes, them sugar puff eyes.
No, I said sugar puff.
Sugar puff eyes?
You look like the sugar puff monster.
If I was built like you, maybe, man.
This is Alhan versus M. Huncho.
This is great. Do you have mirrors in your house?
No, I'm actually, like, I've got a phobia of mirrors.
Really?
No, I don't.
Wait, so, honestly, yeah.
God.
Jokes aside.
Cool.
When do you take the mask off? Because there's people in this room, yeah? It's not Taz. I'm not saying it's Taz. But there's someone in this room, it's definitely not Taz, who said they've seen you without your mask. And apparently, yeah, it wasn't Taz. It wasn't Taz. I'm telling you, it's not
Taz. If it was Taz, you would have said it's Taz.
No, it's not. Who's Taz? Taz? Exactly. No, but... He said he's seen you without your mask. It wasn't Taz that told me. I don't know why I'm saying he, but it wasn't Taz, yeah? Someone in this room.
You are a snitch, bro. You said it wasn't Taz.
Yeah, it's not
like
Taz.
50 times.
Okay,
bro.
So someone
right
in
now,
this room.
If you was in the police
Taz.
Station, they're writing down Taz. Like, you get it?
No, but someone in this room, it was not Taz, said that they saw you without your mask on. And apparently, you had a turkey flag on your keyring. Where's your car keys?
I don't have a turkey flag on my keyring, bro. I just got a little thing that says. Allah on one side, Muhammad on the other.
I said it was a religious thing, I knew it. Okay, I'm going to tell the person he's not Taz.
You keep thinking I'm Turkish. You just want me to
be
part of
your
country.
So what is your background?
My background...
What?
Anonymous.
Italian?
Yeah, something like that, man.
Nah.
That'd be lit.
I'm literally from every continent apart from North America.
Why do we have an obsession with what he looks like? Because even I want to know, but why? Why do I want to know? It's not going to really benefit my life in any capacity.
It's because you just want to put a face to the voice. Nowadays, music is such a thing where you need to have a face to the voice.
Yeah.
Like, when originally, if you go back 60, 70 years ago, it was just for the ears. Now you got this guy playing.
It's the Stig!
So basically, you're just like a radio.
It's the Stig!
What's the Stig?
Bro, the Stig! You don't remember the Stig?
Top Gear, the guy with the helmet on.
Oh shit, it's the Stig!
I don't like driving.
Get one of them cokes, man.
Yeah, that's
alright. Congratulations. Round of applause for the new album.
Thank you.
Huncho Lean the first. You get me?
Everything's good, bro.
What's
man?
Your reaction been like? What's it been? Four days?
It's been good, man. The response has been good. I was with DJ Target yesterday where I saw your big hairy head.
But you didn't do nothing.
Yeah, I'm not going to pull up on you and just start beating you up in the middle of One Extra. Like, you get it? We're both.
You would have beat me up.
Mate, it would be the first time at One Extra some conversations happen, so.
But maybe you got me mistaken with Annie Mac because you got the same hair.
I can't imagine someone to have beef with you or problems with you, bro. Because like, you're a good guy. Like, you get it? He might be a prick. I'll tell you that. He's a fucking cunt, but he's a good youth, man. He's a good guy, man.
Some people have really pulled up on him as well.
I can tell, man. But he just looks like his facial reaction just doesn't change, bro. Like, man.
I don't think it does.
Someone was saying if I would get thumped on the floor. I just keep like laughing.
I think you would.
Yeah, I think you would. Still, you're like a maniac like that, bro.
Is that a joke off?
Say the Turkish word, man. You're Turkish, maniac. But how was so DJ tough. Target? Yeah, I see you on One Extra, man. I was going to pull up, but I thought, nah, let him do his little interview. He's going to do the big thing tomorrow.
Yeah, I said the big thing tomorrow. Yeah, man, it was good, man. I was telling him, I'm just happy that I get to release music and not only me, but other artists as well from different genres. You've got Jay Huss release something. And you've got Maxton as well, I think.
Yeah, Maxton.
That's three different genres. And I feel like listening to my own work and being a fan of Huss's work and listening to Merckson and so on and so forth, even Western released something, like a single, and listening to these tracks in January as well, all this music that's come out from our scene, it's a good look, you know what I'm trying to say? It's a good start to the year, especially on the high note that the artists from last year that dropped the end of last year, Stormzy, I think D-Block as well, a few other artists that dropped, they ended it with a high note and it just started off from that note, you know what I'm trying to say? And I feel like it's just going to have to be consistent throughout the year. And yeah, man, I'm just happy everyone's just doing their thing, man.
Have you got freedom now? Like, you know, for example, when you're an independent artist, everything's on your terms. I understand there's a compromise at the label, but is it too much of a compromise where you can't really do as you please?
I can do whatever the fuck I want.
That is amazing. And
my man just told you that I'm the size of the building. So if you're walking into people that have 9-to-5 jobs, no offence, I don't have anything against 9-to-5. But
nah, you're wet, get out of it, it's a rat race.
This guy's rude. But when you're talking to people that are not from a certain background or they don't have, they might be smart in that department, but they're not smart in any other department. They see things in a corporate point of view. And when you're giving them a different point of view, I don't even have to explain myself furthermore. I just do what I want. If I want to release, no one can tell me to go and do a song about this or do a song for the radio. If something ends up on the radio, it ends up on the radio. Like, I'm not even concerned with numbers. I'm not even concerned with like charting and these things there. That's more of like what labels want. Me personally, bro, I'm just happy to just release music. So I can do whatever I want, put whatever on my tape, get whoever on my tape and just keep it pushing, man. You think they can tell me what to do? No way.
Who's your proudest collaboration so far? I can't lie. I think the Heady tune is probably one of the best collaborations you've done.
My best collaboration... Ask me a hard question there, you fucking yeti.
Don't want to offend anyone though.
To be honest with you, that's the whole point. That's the whole point though, when you're an artist, you're collaborating with other artists. Yeah. So just because you lack or you have a preference to what you lack out of who you've worked with, doesn't mean that the other ones were not adequate enough. Mm. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, 100.
It's completely the opposite. Like, they're all on the same level. But for me, I obviously enjoy working with Nath. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. I've worked with Nath Smalls a lot. Yeah, I would say Nath, man. I enjoy working with him, linking him in the studio. The process is lit. The people around him, good people. You can feel the energy, bro. It's all about the energy you feel when you actually go into like a studio. It's not just pull up there and everyone just sitting there like, do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, gal trying to get drawn and that. Like, it's not that.
I have that problem all the time.
What the hell?
Turks tend to keep the circle quite close. Proper.
All right.
Disclaimer, I'm not Turkish. Don't listen to this guy.
Come on. It's every song, bruv. Ask RB, I get the pack song. Come on, bruv.
Serious?
I said RB.
Yeah, RB. RB means brother.
RB, I know what RB means. Come on, bro. You can't tell me.
Come on, he knows you.
I know what obviously. Wait, hold on. Pause. This guy's talking about Green Lanes, bro. What, you think I don't go Green Lanes?
Of course.
You think I don't eat in Green Lanes?
It's amazing.
You think my man don't give me free stuff when I'm leaving? Come on, man. They respect my thing, fam.
Yeah.
They have to respect my thing, bro. Because I go there without a mask. They don't even know who I am.
Oh, serious?
Obviously not, G. What the fuck, fam?
I'm not going to sit down and eat like that.
I'm for this praying mantis, man.
So, with girls...
I don't link girls, bro.
One minute. What, you gay? You link girls?
No. I don't go out my way to link anyone, to be honest with you.
So you don't have... So, what, you're a virgin? You have sex, right?
Wait, I'm just a top-notch wanker, mate.
I read that. Was it right-hand drive?
Yeah.
Stick.
No, it's a left-hand drive. I'm right-handed, though.
Oh, you sit on it for ages?
Obviously not. That's what weirdos like you do.
All right. Well, I actually link girls.
See you, fam.
What?
101 later on, topless.
Say nothing. Topless?
Maskless as well.
Maskless?
No, I'm joking. Look at you.
You want to do wrestling?
You love it. Yeah.
Do you want to wrestle?
If I wrestle, then right, I can do this. I can be that Nacho Libre guy. Remember?
There's a chip on your...
Kane, he's lit.
Your mask is chipped.
No, it's not.
You are a bowl cat. Sorry. So what? Honestly, do you beat girls with a mask on? Because I ask a lot of rappers this, who wear the mask.
No, bro. Like, I don't...
That'd be really scary.
I've got a girl, innit? I don't do that.
Oh, okay. So what, are you just like, it's 50-50? Because
looking at... 50-50, nothing, because listen to this. Like, I'll go to a show, I'll perform, I'm here to do a job, I leave.
Yeah.
I got bottles, I don't drink. They bring me Ryder, 4 or 5 bottles. Either one of the mandem takes it, puts it in their mini bar that looks like a fucking boss man's off license, or man's walking through the crowd and man's just giving it over to any youth man see or anyone that just looks like they're just everyone. Having a good time.
Yeah.
I'll be cool. Like, yo, bro, here, hold that. Cool. One bottle right. down. We've got that four more cold. To give away. Cars at the back exit, jump in the car, off.
Only and you didn't only, invite man to the team.
Only Turks say exit. Because it's exit, but exit.
Bro.
And then you jump in your Mercedes.
I've already told you what I think about Mercedes.
What car do you drive?
Wow.
I drive a Mercedes.
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 Well, I bet it's white. Is it?
No, obviously not.
What? Go on.
It's a black Mercedes.
Classic. If it were going to be white,
what Mercedes is it? You don't know nothing about
E-Class
cars.
Coupe.
No way. E-class.
No, 4x4. Something SUV.
No.
Don't tell me it's A-Class.
No.
13 plate.
No.
I don't know nothing about cars, but you look like
this guy, mad. Yeah, he doesn't know. You look like you're one of them Muppets that man see in Central, just driving on your 1,000-pound pedal bike trying to get to your job wearing like, slim, thick fucking clothing, but fuck all of that with your camel toe just hanging out. Like, you know what I'm trying to say? That's what you're on. You can imagine them. You know them guys? I swear to God, I had a t-shirt in college that looks exactly like Alhan, and he was on this tight cycle.
So you don't get girls?
No.
I won't. I rate it. So, do you have kids and stuff? Do you have a life outside of... What's your life outside of music?
Why are you laughing, bro? You're a father, fam. I was the dad laughing at me, like, when a man's asking me questions. And by the way, I have no kids. But how are you laughing, bro?
Can I explain?
No, you can't. Oh, they go to places that I'm not living in. That's what you said, bro. Your kids are actually very cute, man. So, props to you, man. I just hope. Yeah,
Poet smashed it. Poet smashed it, man.
Shout out to Poet, man. He's a
decent sperm.
Cool, well done. But how the fuck is he laughing, bro?
Can I explain?
Go on, explain.
One second, this guy's taking the piss out of you, and then he tries to just go and have a serious conversation
about children, bro.
He's talking about cars and all of this, and he's like, so do you have a family? I'm just like, how did we get there?
I told
in
you,
that
fam.
Head, what is going on?
Bro, it's the hair, fam. It's not even the head, fam. There's nothing in there, fam. It's like that fucking Homer Simpson x-ray scan, bro.
The
x-ray scan, bro, where the brain is this big and it's just wired up and the head's this huge.
You got a really deep voice. It's quite like pillow talk must be...
It's like a pillow
you
talk,
could just bro. Get girls.
You do that with that.
You could just call... You'd
probably do that with Amelia, to be fair.
Yeah, we pillow talk about content. Last night we were in bed, I was like, so tell me about Mehmet.
Oh, bro.
She said you couldn't get it up.
Whoa.
Mate. Let's not even get onto that
No,
topic.
So what's your life like that's not music?
What's your life like?
You can take your mask off and walk around and no one will clock you. But the only thing is...
My voice is very distinctive.
Your voice is distinctive. Yeah. The way you speak is exit. It's distinctive, very distinctive. But also it's the way you're built as well.
Oh my God.
No, because really. there's not a lot of rappers that look like you.
But there's a lot of human beings that look like me.
Yeah.
You're like an improper faction or whatever, is it top heavy?
I would say I'm heavy.
How long you been skipping leg day?
You think I skip leg day, bro? Are you serious?
Know. I got bigger calves than you, man.
You got bigger calves than me?
Yeah.
Bro, I'll push your whole family on the leg press. I guarantee you that. Bring them.
Are you sure? Gym, that's a big, I can't lie.
Bro, you go, we'll go for time, bro.
Hey, how was gym yesterday?
It's amazing.
Yeah.
What did you work on?
I'm not quite sure. It really hurts. My body really
hurts. What hurts?
Here, just everywhere.
Do you know what these are called?
Shoulders?
Yeah, well done.
Head, shoulders.
10 points to Gryffindor.
Oh my God, I had an audition for that as well.
What, Harry Potter?
Yeah.
What are you going to be? The next Neek that tries to bully people?
Nah, he's going to be the token black guy.
He was going to be the broom that they play.
What's my man's name? The one from...
We know who you would have been.
Yeah, angry.
I think like, you'll be Malfoy.
I'll probably be in a broom, but I'm cool with that.
Who's Malfoy?
That's pagan.
Malfoy Huncho.
That's, sounds like it makes sense,
it
though.
Does, yeah.
You see the quiet? They have to cover it up with chat.
You covered your whole face up, you
cunt. Yeah?
Did you see that thing I done where that girl called me the N-word?
Yeah.
I put a picture up of my Instagram, like, what's wrong with this girl? She's been harassing bare people. Bare people just sent me her address.
It's long.
Bro, it's easy to do that nowadays.
Exactly.
That is mad.
I just got to school with one guy, and he was like, I bet you can't find anything of me. I'm not online. Password, his mum's Facebook password, his address, his iCloud, everything.
How?
It's called doxing, isn't it? Back in the day, I used to do that bare, man.
Ross,
that's how you know this guy's wanted in 19 different countries. I wasn't wrong, bro.
You're definitely not wrong. Them CIA man there. Good, fam.
Trust me, bro. How do you think I got on the show with you?
I thought we were friends.
Nah.
You deezed it. My brother, I respect it, man.
You get me? But anyway, back to M. Huncho. What are you saying now? Has the reaction been good to the album?
Sorry, I'm just trying to like...
What?
Take you in, fam. You're just...
You want to take me in?
Not like...
So you don't sleep with girls, you want to take me in? You're very olive. You're darker than I am.
Yeah, I'm dark, mate. I'm darker than this guy.
You are darker than Poet, actually.
Poet's right, light. Yeah. Poet's light as same well. We're like the same complexion, yeah. But a different...
Pakistani?
Nah.
Maybe he's black.
I'm not going to tell you guys where I'm from.
All right.
I know that.
Never. But on some real shit, like a lot of people are... They have no lives, bro.
Trust me.
Social media is everything to them. Life is bigger than social media, bro. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
100%.
If you're not going to brand yourself, if you're not going to take yourself anywhere with social media, then there's no point. Unless, obviously, you're married, you've got a private account, or you know what I'm trying to say? You're doing your thing on the D-Low. I just feel like a lot of people are in it just for the sake of it, fam.
Big man. You seem to have that unlock, and is that the big reason for the mask?
What, in terms of privacy?
Yeah.
Personally, bro, I feel like there's more life beyond what man's doing, bro. Mm. Like...
Because if
a musician's career, realistically, in the genre and the world we're in right now, is kind of similar to a footballer's, bro. Mm. Footballers retire, what, 35, 36, 37? Yeah. That's around the times that people will leave what they're doing, and all the income that they've made from whatever they were doing will now be a surviving thing. Now they're surviving with that money because they don't have any other way to make money. They don't have another income. Yeah. They can't put themselves to use because now they're confused. They left the only thing they knew behind to now do something
different,
which is nothing because they were so comfortable. So, you know, it's a weird one, man.
If it makes a lot of sense though, because when you expose your face on camera earlier, your personality and all of that, it's kind of like a tattoo. Like, it's there for life, innit? And if later on down the line you want to change, if people can see your face, they're going to be like, nah, you're the same person. With you, you can come out 10 years from now, do something completely different, and no one will even know you're M. Huncho. That is lit.
It's not even just that, bro. Like, personally, whenever like things calm down a little bit or I have more time on my hands, I'm probably going to go back into education and just try to get smack out a degree in something, you know what I'm trying to say?
Serious?
Something to do with like technology or sciences or something like that. Obviously, educating yourself is a big thing. I don't believe in getting educated, but bro, I went to a shit school. Like, we didn't really get taught anything that we're using in our current life right now. So that's the first thing. And the second thing is, bro, like I was saying this, I had a Rap Genius breakdown about one of the tracks on my tape. And I was saying this in the beginning, like, I can't be walking down the road and I have a man coming up to me and trying to ask me for a picture because I'll punch man in the face. And I'm saying this, let me tell you why. No, I'm not saying this, I'll punch a random person in the face because everywhere you get is because of the fans. So it's more, I'm saying this in context of walking with your child or your family or you're walking with... It's not even a headache, bro.
Like, for me, it's a headache.
You're putting the child in a weird place. Like, do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, they might get scared, bro. Children are children, bro. Like,
of course.
They won't understand that, especially when
they're
young.
So you do have kids?
I don't, bro, but I relate. Like, do you know what I'm trying to say?
But it's true, though, because you're the one who signed up for that lifestyle. It shouldn't affect those around you.
And it does, you know. 100% affects everyone around you. Like, all down to mummy and them things. It affects everyone.
Obviously, bro. And that's the reason. Man can't be given into all of them type of things. That at the end of the day, bro, you guys leave these seats. You might still be the same people, but you have different lives. Like, this thing that we're in is just like a little bubble, man.
Yeah, it is a bubble. That's the thing.
But the good thing is when you know that you can leave the bubble whenever you like. Do you know what I'm trying to say? Like, that's all it's about.
I feel like Poet and me are able to leave the bubble when we want, but if we had the mask, it would help a lot.
Mask off.
No, but you know what it is? You can't do that now.
It's too late for me.
Yeah, of course. It's way too late.
You have to do it from the get-go. Like, yeah, for me, 100%. It started with a belly, bro, with like a, you know, them Finsulate things that man used to grab for £1 just in case, like, it gets cold.
Do videos exist of you rapping or performing without a belly?
Never.
Back in the day?
Never. I never used to make music back in the day.
Swear.
I've always been a consumer until 3 years ago. I never knew anything about music, making music. Huh? My career was on a 9-to-5.
Construction?
Yeah, logistics.
Logistics?
Yeah.
DPD?
No, deeper than that.
Your new song, PP, is one of my favourites, and the music video is incredible. What was the budget on that?
That like a big budget video,
bro. I can't even tell you, bro.
PP! So you literally took a song, I mean, you took the piss, quite literally.
I literally did, yeah.
And was that middle finger to the industry? Like, I'm just going to make a song and I'm going to auto-tune PP.
The PP was actually done myself with a high tone of voice.
Yeah. No auto-tune?
I use auto-tune, but very, like, minimal. Yeah.
Auto-tune isn't, like, I think people think it just...
It depends on what context you use it.
Yeah, 100%.
Like, you have to, there's professional singers, bro, that will use like some sort of voice tuning and certain keys that they can't hit and whatnot.
Where did you guys shoot the video? Where was it?
It was in between LA and Vegas.
Okay.
Jesus.
Route 66.
For you, it'll be Route 69, bro.
Very good. Stig.
Stink.
Turk.
Go for days. That was
where was it there?
Drink.
LA and Vegas. Drink, you know. I was wearing a jacket.
And a mask, you were wearing a jacket. But deserts aren't always necessarily hot.
Like mad cold at night, bro.
Yeah.
Bro, it's not even a night thing.
It was like, a daytime.
It was like a hoodie weather. Yeah, literally a hoodie and no shorts, no nothing. But it was cold, bro. Nighttime, it went to -1, -2, and windy, and it was freezing, bro. But that video. Yeah, a man had to drive there 2.5-3 hours to get there from LA. So in the morning, stopped by a Chick-fil-A. Best thing ever. Shall I tell you why? I stopped at Chick-fil-A around the same time as that the man would stop at McDonald's brekkie. Yeah.
Aye.
Now listen to this. I told him, can I order normal food and not the breakfast menu? They said, yeah, of course you can. And boom, there I was sitting with a fucking...
That was your highlight?
That was my highlight, bro. Food is my highlight.
I mean, same, but... Always, it's always my highlight.
But you come here with all the Haribos.
No. Stuff, I like food, proper food.
What's proper food?
Gokuses.
Yeah, but Gokuses, you can have that at home.
No, I can't. Yeah, it's not the same. You can't do the whole charcoal grill and the juices.
You got a big house, so I think you can.
No.
You're Turkish. Your mum cooks, right?
Yeah, of course.
She's probably an excellent cook.
But there's home food, and then there's like the food that you get in a restaurant.
Is there pork and bacon cooked in your own home?
No, I will cook that. I cook it. My parents won't cook it. They don't eat pork.
You cook it? Bacon. They allow you to cook it?
Yeah.
They allow you to cook it there with one of their pans?
It's not a fucking dictatorship. What?
You had a good home.
No, I have a...
It is a dictatorship. Yeah. That's what he does.
They give me a small pan. It's called the Young Teflon.
See, you're a funny guy, man.
I know.
Do you know who you remind me of?
Go on.
You might be like a retarded Seth Rogen. with like long hair. And your barber's scared of you. You know what I would love to see? I know you've come by the videos on Instagram and you see a man getting a trim because they're looking shabby. Yeah. Like,
they're homeless before. My friend done one.
Before and after. Ooh, your hairline. Non-existent. You might have to go back to Turkey and grab that.
They get the stick and they start hitting you with it on the fire.
What?
You haven't seen a Turkish barbershop? They put wax in your ear and then they hit you with fire.
One time there was a video of a guy's hair that all went on fire and the man's all smacking his head.
Obviously, I was just about to say, he's your barber, but... It looks
like it's honestly, he's in pen for serving life.
Serving life is when he has to cut my hair. That's a life sentence, bro.
How long has it been, though, man?
I think like 4 years, 5 years.
You're going to cut it, like, one day you're just going to cut me.
Do you have a picture of how you looked before?
Yeah.
Can I see it?
It's political still.
It's on my gram still.
It's on Paul's gram.
Yeah, but it's not on
And he used the word ting.
And he used the word ting.
Tinking about
how was he looking?
To me, let me know he's Jamaican. It says, thinking about things.
Man said thinking about
things. Oh, thinking about things. Thinking about things. Not even thinking about things. This guy was a yard man from early.
The only yardie in private school.
You went to private school?
Yeah.
Where'd you go? Eton?
Nah, Eton isn't a... That's a whole other level.
So your cousins with Boris Johnson, though?
Yeah, of course. I left that to him. I'll take over shortly, one day.
You'll take up.
I'm running for Mayor of London. That's my thing.
Mayor of Green Lanes. Sounds
I'm already Mayor of Green Lanes.
That's a lie.
Yeah. But why? Who's Mayor of Green Lanes? You?
No, I don't want to show your face. Please believe me. I don't want to be.
Where are you from? Northwest. Whereabouts?
Northwest in general, bro. I'm from everywhere.
I love this. You'll never know the information.
Besides you have to be from everywhere.
Yeah, I eat from everywhere. So yeah, man.
You eat from everywhere. You don't eat down there, though.
I know, but you do.
Yeah.
Route 69.
You know what? Props to the mask, though.
Yeah.
Because it's a very good quality mask. Because LDZ is just like the Phantom of the Opera one and it's cut at the bottom. Cassie's dead one is hard, but it's like a pre-made one. Your one is, you've gone in. There was a whole, I remember you done the whole campaign behind it.
Yeah. But what's going to happen is...
There's going to be a new mask.
I'm just going to take it off.
When?
Live on Gasworks.
Go on, then.
Joke, man. Don't clap.
Do you have
psych! Hair? You thought... It's all right, though.
Do you have hair?
Do I have hair? Yeah, of course I do. Not like you, though, little bitch.
I am your little bitch, M. Huncho.
Oh, for fuck's sake, bro.
There are so many sound bites and memes from this whole
blushing,
ep,
bro. Guy.
You're blushing?
Nah, I'm not.
Don't blush.
Believe me, I'm not. He's just jealous, bro.
Who, Poet?
Yeah, because someone might replace him on that seat right there.
Not really, I've got a couple of other
You don't have to sit on that seat. Right. You don't have to sit on that seat.
I know this guy's tired of you.
We could share the same seat.
That is...
Whoa. Santa Claus.
That is... Don't do that.
But, well, what's happening this year? You got another album coming or are you done?
I'm not done at all, bro.
At all?
At all. I just went into third gear and there's 12 gears. I'm driving an 18-wheeler.
Gross.
So...
I know it's an 18-wheeler, I can tell.
100%. It's not a 20-wheeler, though, I'll tell you that.
Is it a 20-wheeler?
Bro, you look about 6 months into your pregnancy right now.
It is you two on a walk.
All I want to know is what gender is it and what the name is, if it's Mehmet or
not. I'm not going to assign it any gender.
We need to make celebrity deathmatch. You two need to have clay models.
We could
fighting.
Do roast wars.
Why
you know
don't
what?
We do celebrity boxing?
This is
man?
All I've been fucking. No.
Well, I'm not boxing,
not violence,
I'll tell you
not
that.
Violence, not violence. Mm-mm,
not
why?
Gym,
why?
Why is that violence, bro?
What, boxing?
It's a sport.
Nah. Cuz not the sport.
It's a violent sport.
Is
yeah.
What? Is darts, yeah, is darts a sport? Is darts a sport? Come on.
It is a sport.
It's a hobby and they've made money and.
So it's a sport?
Nah. It's not a sport. I don't okay, think it's a sport.
Boxing is a sport, but it's a violent
you're
sport.
Telling me dance is not a sport?
Dance.
Anything that involves like a physical, recreational activity.
Darts.
Yeah, darts is not a sport. It's for people like you, bruv.
Yeah, right.
But darts is
what
sport.
What do you mean? You look more like a fucking darts player than I do.
How the fuck do I look like a darts
you
player?
Yeah, both look player. Like darts players, for fuck's sake.
I'm fine. You look like a dart.
I am a dart. So you not gonna chuck me?
Listen, you look like a dart. Nah, I'm not gonna lie. You don't. Don't listen to
Porky,
this.
Porky. I want to know where you're from. You can tell me after the interview's over and we'll just put a disclaimer or something. Well, what other questions have you got?
Wait, why do you want to know so bad? Because I'm trying to figure out why I
want to know. What's so bad?
Where why do you want to know?
Because the voice and the accent is something that is local to me, I feel.
But when you not find really. Out, then what?
Not really, bro. You got people from... Like Bangladesh that will say I'm from their country, bro, but you just seen when I stood, I'm 6'4", bro. I don't think I've ever come across a Bangladeshi that's 6'4".
What, Bangladeshi people are all short?
So at least we can rule something out, though. If we take a look at it, like,
okay, so you're not
from Bangladesh, all right.
Obviously not.
Okay. New Zealand.
Algeria. Iran.
No comment.
Team Iran.
I'm not Iran.
Snow Allegra. Canada?
Canada?
Bro, I'm trying to just take things off the list.
I'm not so going to lie to you. You're British born, so you're going to have to sit this one out.
Is it?
Because you're just going to give me Canada, North America, Milwaukee?
Yeah, because then we can narrow it down to what I believe it to be.
Okay, what do you believe it to be?
Somewhere in around the area of Turkey.
Turkey and the area around it is huge, you know.
I know.
It's huge. But yeah,
I was going to say somewhere
around them sides, man.
Somewhere around them? I said that. When I said you're local to me, you said not really.
No, but local to you can mean your neighbouring country, bro. How many neighbouring countries have you got right now? You got Syria.
Syria. What else is there? Bulgaria.
Bulgaria. Israel's a couple things down.
So you're Israeli?
No, I'm not.
Palestinian?
Really. I don't know. Yeah, something like that, maybe.
You said it. You're Palestinian?
No, I'm not. But
no, you are. It came out.
Okay, cool. I am.
I don't believe it. There you have it. M. Huncho came out on Gasworks, everyone.
Wow.
I said came out on Gasworks like I was in the closet, but...
Okay. But you do look like a closet, come on. You just, like, you're boxed. That's the thing, you're very compact. Like, a lot of people kind of grow outwards, but you just grow, like, squashed.
Why do you have so much bad things to say?
No, it's not bad. Look at you.
And I'm like, bro,
why do you have a Rockstar logo on your jacket?
Come on, bro. It's the lifestyle, man.
It's not the lifestyle, bro.
It is the lifestyle.
You just look like one of the wankers that sit in front of GTA and wanking prostitutes.
Yeah, that's all I do.
You wanking prostitutes?
Yeah.
That jacket he got because he got the most wanks recorded. on for a GTA prostitute.
No, but listen, honestly, you're one of my favourite guests.
Thank you.
I wish we could have much longer, but yeah, we got other people in the way.
Don't send me off like that, though. It's not
how would you like me to send you off?
Thank you for coming. Really enjoyed the conversation.
It's a poet thing, right?
All right, go on. Let Poet sign
off. No pregnant ladies.
Thank you so much for coming. Really enjoyed. Sorry. Thank you for insulting Alhan and myself.
I didn't insult you. I'm not gonna lie though, he did look like one of them French mime artist painters with that hat and that, bro, and the strap t-shirt.
I think that was so lit.
You're looking like Where's Poet? Literally.
Where's? I don't mind though. My whole life's been a joke. At least I get paid for it. And on that note, take care. Told you mom I could do it.